Hello all, Pete Brooker here from Tailors with Love. In this video, I'm going to give you a 10-minute guide on James Bond locations that you'll find in the Bahamas. This is more of a travel guide than a style guide, but at the end of the video, I'll give you a roundup of some of the garments I wore and how you can dress like Bond on your travels. So Bond arrives by seaplane because it looks sexy. He touches down outside the Atlantis Hotel that you can see in the background. And so if you've arrived by cruise ship, you'll go over Sydney Poitier Bridge to get to the Atlantis. And our taxi driver told us that it was the Atlantis in Dubai that was featured in Casino Royale, which I found very hard to believe as the Dubai Atlantis was opened 2 years after the release of Casino Royale. I didn't bother correcting him. So after Bond arrives, he picks up a Ford rental and drives to what was then the one and only club, which is now the Ocean Club under Four Seasons management. You'll notice he's actually in disguise here, as costume designer Lindy Hemming gave him a shirt with epaulettes so he could pass as a security guard. So here Bond drives past Compass Point Hotels, distinguished by the colourful wall and multicoloured annex roofs. Sadly, that wall has now been painted over and looks a bit more austere. And here's us driving down that stretch in the track tyres of Bond, so to speak. Now this is Love Beach, the other side of Compass Point, which is where Bond pins Vargas to the tree in Thunderball. You won't find that particular tree. A lot of the landscape and locations have changed over the years due to hurricanes, but I did get some sand in a bottle to add to my Bond Beach collection. So these are locations you'll find on the way to Paradise Island if you're following Bond's footsteps. It's all a bit backwards and you'll probably only do this route if you landed at the airport and not at the harbour. But you'll drive past Palmyra, which was Largo's gaff in Thunderball, which is locked up and patrolled by two very hungry looking dogs. This is how the shark pool looks now. You can see this from the breakwater. And I hope they do something with this place. It's such a shame that it's, you know, deteriorated and not. So across from Palmyra, you'd actually see some of the caves that was featured in a small scene when Bond gets picked up by Fiona Volpe. Some men don't like being taken for a ride. I've always liked that line. So here we are at the Ocean Club. Now you can visit here as a guest if you're eating and drinking in their bars and restaurants. This is the car park that Bond crashes the 4x4 in. I actually took this photo, then got told to beat it by the security guards, which is, you know, absolutely fair enough. Oh, and here I am on the Solange hammock, as it's officially known. So this is the bar that they did the poker scene in. That piano is where the poker table was, and they have some nice photos dotted around. They're very proud of the Bond Association, it seems. So then we got the shuttle over to Atlantis, and this is to hunt down the Thunderball water breaker. And it's easy enough to find between Cabbage Beach and the resort. It's right by the lockers, which you have to pay $17 for. Jesus Christ. By the way, if you're not a guest at the hotel, you'll have to pay $135 to get to this spot, or $75 for the beach pass. So, you know. My missus is the best, by the way, if I haven't told you all. And if I haven't told you, darling, and you're listening or watching this, you are the best. Look at you walking across here, risking life and limb. So you're not allowed down here, but we snuck down. And if you're attempting this, be careful because it's rough terrain. And we got the shot, which was nice, and then got told to move along by the lifeguard. Again, absolutely fair enough. Back in Nassau now, and we went looking for a couple of the Junkanoo scenes. Whilst you're on that street, check out the Matisse Cafe for something to eat. Order the duck, not the ceviche. That's the best tip I'll give you. Now onto a few Never Say Never Again locations. You'll find this one easy enough down at the harbour where Nigel gives away Bond's identity. And now just on from the harbour, you'll see this bar and grill, which is about a year or so old. It was originally called the Never Say Never Again Bar and Grill because it's the spot where Bond meets Fatima Blush. The original waterfront, that's long gone. And it had to change its name, though, because of licensing regulations. They didn't, you know, get it cleared. So Eon just came down and said, what the fuck are you doing down here? But if you look carefully, you can still see some of the original markings. They had to repaint all the artwork inside the bar as well, because it was all Bond-related, pictures of Bond. Although one painting of Sean Connery, they just painted him into a pyro. And this could be my favourite photo of the whole holiday. So there's also this location close by the harbour, which is actually a government house, so you'll need to be quick to get your shot. It's all remarkably similar to the movie, with the exception of the wheelchair ramp, which is now in place. That's the cockroach I found when I checked into the hotel. I think it died of old age. I don't know why I've included that. I just thought I'd break up the flow. Okay, here we go. This is the construction site that was featured in the foot chase in Casino Royale. We hired a car to get there because it's at the southwest tip of the island in Coral Harbour. We parked up, asked the security guards on the gate if it was okay to get photos. The security took our passport details at one point, and I thought we were going to get in, but they said no. It was a false optimism on my part. We parked our car here, where the trees are. They've all been felled since the film. And now if you turn south from the construction site and follow the beach down, you'll get to a really cool location. This is the snake pit mongoose fight scene.
He's on the move. He's on the move and he's heading straight for me.
Stop touching your ear.
Sorry? Put your hand down.
Now, the last location I wanted to see was the Albany house where Demetrius lived. So this is a private resort that I think was founded by Ernie Els and Tiger Woods. You can't just rock up and have drinks here, like you can in the Ocean Club, unfortunately. However, if you head down to Stewart's Cove, you can walk to this stretch of the beach. You'll have a nice tour of some dilapidated buildings, some ruins. On the other side of this pier is where the resort is, and they have big double back off, get the fuck out of here signs, so we didn't go in beyond that point. But the sea is shallow enough, so you can head all the way out and get a close enough shot. Close-ish, like we did. But careful, don't get your cameras wet. So that was fun. We did speak to one guy on the beach who was out walking his dog, and he said that the Albany is buying up all of this beach on this side as well. So soon enough, you won't even be able to get to this point. So that's it. I hope this was of some entertainment as well as some use, and not just me going through my holiday photos, just dumping all of my holiday photos and videos on you all. But there you go. There you go. That's what you get. And, oh, quick mention about the wardrobe. I did promise you. So if you want to get the Bond look, you can buy the Sunspell Riviera Polo that Bond wore in the Ocean Club. There was some camp collar shirts by Mason & Sons. And if you want to support British manufacturing, then be sure to check out the Hemingsworth brand. I'm wearing their shorts right here. And I'll leave all the links below. Until next time.